Hello everyone, welcome to this first session on head and neck. So as per request from all students, I am beginning with the head and neck sessions. In this session, we'll be starting with the skull bone. Skull forms the basis of the head and neck, and that's why we are starting with this bone. In the head and neck region, the bones which are included are, one is the skull, then other is the cervical vertebrae, which are 7 in number, then hyoid bone. Okay, these are the bones included in head and neck. So let's start with the skull. So what is the difference between skull and cranium? At times, many students get confused pertaining to this topic and they consider both as synonymous. So you should be knowing what is the difference between the skull and the cranium. What we can see in this image, this is the skull. Okay, then what is cranium? If we remove the mandible, if mandible is removed, then whatever part of the skull is left, that is referred to as cranium. Okay. So basically, cranium is skull without mandible. Okay, with mandible, this entire thing is considered as skull. How to hold the skull in anatomical position? In anatomical position, the skull has to be held in such a way that this part is anterior, this part is posterior, superior and inferior. Okay, with both hands you have to hold the skull, and these two planes are important. Here we can say this is the orbital margin. Okay, this is the inferior margin of the orbital foramen, this point, and the upper margin of the external acoustic meatus. This opening which we can see, this is the external acoustic meatus. So if we draw an imaginary line joining these two points, the inferior margin of the orbit and the superior margin of the external acoustic meatus, this line is referred to as Frankfurt's plane. Okay. So while holding the skull in anatomical position, it has to be held in such a way that these two points lie in one horizontal plane. Okay. And there is one more line described with respect to the anatomical position of skull, that is Reed's baseline. In this, one point is constant, that is the inferior margin of the orbit, and other point it passes through the middle of the external acoustic meatus. Okay. For Reed's baseline, the posterior point is, it's at the center of the external acoustic meatus. Okay. Either of the two you can remember, but more preferably, Frankfurt's plane is preferred for holding the skull in anatomical position. Now let's see the parts of the skull. In general, skull can be divided into two parts. One is referred to as the cranial skeleton, another is referred to as the facial skeleton. Okay, cranial skeleton is also referred to as neurocranium, and facial skeleton is also referred to as viscerocranium. So briefly, you can get an idea of which part is cranial skeleton, which part is facial skeleton with these images. This is the lateral view and this is the anterior view of the skull. Okay, facial skeleton is more on the anterior aspect. Okay, whereas remaining part of the skull is cranial skeleton. We'll see which all bones are included in these two parts of the skull. So here we can see the bones forming the cranial skeleton as well as bones forming the facial skeleton. In all, in the skull has got 22 bones, excluding the ear ossicles. Okay, if ear ossicles are included, it becomes 28. Because 3 ear ossicles on each side, so it will add 6 more bones. Okay. So cranial skeleton, it includes paired bones and unpaired bones. Paired bones are parietal bone and temporal bone. This is the parietal bone. This is the temporal bone. And unpaired bones are frontal bone, and behind there will be occipital bone, then sphenoid bone and ethmoid bone. These are unpaired bones of the cranial skeleton. And facial skeleton, it has got total of 14 bones. Here also there are paired and unpaired bones. First, we can remember the unpaired. One is the mandible, another is the vomer. This is mandible, and vomer is the midline bone. When we see the nasal cavity, the bone with a thin bone seen in the midline will be vomer. Okay. Other paired bones in the facial skeleton are maxilla, zygomatic, nasal bone, lacrimal bone, palatine bone, and inferior nasal concha. Okay, all these are included in paired bones of the facial skeleton. Okay, Here we can see this is the maxilla, and this is the zygomatic bone. Here is the nasal bone. Okay. Lacrimal bones and palatine bones are here. Then inferior nasal concha, it's a separate bone in the lateral wall of the nose. Okay. So all these are the components of the skull which we should be aware of. Now let's see the joints formed by the skull. In skull, all bones are united by fibrous joint. Fibrous joint is a type of solid joint, and those are referred to as sutures. Okay, except one joint, that is temporomandibular joint, which is a synovial variety of joint. Okay, so almost all bones are united by fibrous joint, which are referred to as suture, except one joint, which is synovial, that is the temporomandibular joint. If you see the bones of the ossicles, those are also synovial. Those are not included in joints of the skull. Okay, that has to be considered separately. Let's see the difference between an adult skull and a fetal skull. So here we can see this is the adult skull viewed from the anterior aspect. This is the fetal skull viewed from the anterior aspect. The one most striking difference which we can see between these two skull is, see the proportion of the facial skeleton here, and see the proportion of facial skeleton here. Okay, facial skeleton is very less developed in a fetal skull. The cranial skeleton is more developed because of the growth of the brain. Okay, so facial skeleton is very small in a fetal skull, and facial skeleton is well developed in an adult skull when viewed from the anterior aspect. And here we can see this region is the region of fontanelle. This is the anterior fontanelle of the skull. Fontanelles are replaced by sutures in adult skull. So in the skull here, there will be a coronal suture, a sagittal suture, which will be meeting at a point that is referred to as bregma. And here we can see a suture which is connecting the two frontal bones. If it persists in adult, it is referred to as metopic suture. Okay, most of the time it is fused. And when seen from the lateral aspect, there is one important feature which is seen on the lateral aspect. This is the mastoid process. Okay, mastoid process is seen well developed in an adult skull. It is not developed in the fetal skull. Okay, it develops due to the pull of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. It starts developing at the age of 2 years. Okay, so these are some differences between an adult skull and fetal skull. And fontanelles, if we see, there are 6 fontanelles. One is the anterior fontanelle, one is the posterior fontanelle, then anterolateral, posterolateral on each side. Okay, so all these fontanelles will be fused in an adult skull. So let's summarize what we have covered in this session. We started with the introduction of the skull. We saw what is the difference between skull and cranium. Skull without mandible is considered as cranium. Okay. In anatomical position of the skull, we saw the skull has to be held in anatomical position in such a way that the inferior margin of the orbit and the superior margin of the external acoustic meatus should lie in one horizontal plane. That line is referred to as Frankfurt's plane. In parts of the skull, we saw there is a cranial skeleton and facial skeleton. We saw various bones forming the cranial skeleton, various bones forming the facial skeleton. Then in joints, almost all bones are united by sutures, except one joint, that is temporomandibular joint, that is a synovial joint. Okay, whereas other joints are the fibrous joints. Okay, then we saw differences between the adult skull and fetal skull. Okay, so this was just an introductory lecture of the skull. In subsequent sessions, I'll be covering the various parts of the skull, the exterior of the skull, the interior of the skull. These are the various headings in which the exterior of the skull is studied. Norma verticalis, norma occipitalis, frontalis, lateralis, basalis. Okay, so all these topics we'll be covering in the subsequent sessions. Okay. Thank you.